Michigan Magazine is kept on the road by our many Michigan friends. Cops and Donuts Bakery, downtown Clare. A winning combination. Cops and Donuts. The Michigan-made rebounding mailbox pole. Never again worry about the winter snowplow taking out your mailbox with this ingenious rebounding pole. Your mailbox takes a hit and keeps coming back year after year. Call now or visit their website, toughmailboxes.com. Something special's cooking, hot and delicious. Indulge yourself at Morning at Maggie's in Bay City. Omelets, frittatas, hotcakes, and more. Make every day special with a stop at Morning at Maggie's for breakfast or lunch on Saginaw in Bay City. On this week's Michigan Magazine, it's back in time as we slip up and away at the Battle Creek Balloon Festival circa 1992. Wow, have they come a long way. Our digging through the archives shows a time when the festival highlighted some historic events, including the appearance of the Walt Disney World 20th Anniversary Cinderella's Castle Balloon. Hey, is that me in the balloon with pilot Dave Justice? Oh my goodness, have we changed. But changes at the new Balloon Festival in Battle Creek are amazing. We'll give you the dates of this year's big event, so stay tuned. Also on the show, the debut of Uncle Cliff's Kitchen with guest chef and Bay City Cafe owner Rod Nimtz. Rod and Uncle Cliff will be preparing French toast a la Bananas Foster for the audience and crew. It was so good. It's all coming up on Michigan Magazine. Cops and Donuts Bakery, downtown Clare. What began as a crazy idea among 9 police officers to purchase the historic Clare City Bakery quickly became an international phenomenon, carrying on a Michigan tradition with delicious donuts, pies, pastries, breads, original coffee, and more, plus a full menu at the new adjacent Traffic Stop Diner. Downtown Clare, a winning combination. Cops and Donuts. Clemex Sales and Service on Mapes Road, west of Mile, your complete recreational vehicle sales and service connection. Visit their beautiful showroom of new and pre-owned ATVs, lawnmowers, power equipment, snowmobiles, utility vehicles, and more. Clemex Sales and Service is also the home of the American-made Victory motorcycle line on display at Clemex on Mapes Road, Mile. From all over the world and the nation, hot air balloon enthusiasts converge on Battle Creek for the annual Battle Creek International Balloon Championship and Air Show. Every year for a week, competition and recreational balloonists fill the skies over Battle Creek with their hot air balloons, creating a colorful spectacle that draws spectators from around the world. Hot air ballooning is one of the oldest means of transportation in the world. Nowadays, though, this means of free flight is being used most effectively as an advertising tool, as was relayed to us by Tucker Comstock of the world's largest manufacturer of hot air balloons, Cameron Balloons of Dexter, Michigan.
Companies have discovered the real advantages of balloon advertising, and companies that have been sort of lost in the overall media glut have discovered that this is a very refreshing and high impact kind of marketing. So when Kodak, for example, decided to investigate balloon programs, they discovered that the Albuquerque Balloon Fiesta, which is an annual event in Albuquerque, New Mexico every October, there's more film sold in Albuquerque for that event than any other event in the world each year, the exception being the Olympics.
A couple of well-known Cameron balloon creations include Disney's Air Force One, which besides being a wonderful form of advertising, proved to be a unique and creative tool for diplomatic goodwill. David Justice, who piloted Air Force One behind the Iron Curtain, was at this year's Battle Creek Balloon Fest, this time piloting another Cameron balloon, Disney's Castle in the Sky. This replica of Cinderella's Castle is one of the tallest balloons ever made. The average balloon is about 65 to 75 feet in height, while the castle, when fully inflated, blossoms to a height of 145 feet. We talked with David Justice about the Castle in the Sky and his trip in Air Force One over Russia.
How long have you been a pilot for Disney?
Since 1986, when we bought the first balloon. So we've been with the program the whole time.
Now this balloon has been all over the world.
This one was did Euro Disney. It was brand new back in end of September, 1st of October for the Walt Disney World 20th celebration. And we did a 13-city tour of cities in the east, all the way up as far north as Toronto, and flights over Niagara Falls. And in the month of April, we were in France for the Euro Disney opening. We've done Tokyo Disneyland. We did one tour over there for about 5 weeks with Donald.
This is kind of a labor of love, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. It started out years ago as a hobby for me, and finally decided, you know, well, geez, maybe we could do this for a living, or at least an existence. And it is. I love ballooning. And of course, everybody says, well, balloonists just have a big ego. So, you know, obviously, I must have a very large one. I don't know.
We've been talking with the balloonists in the area, and they can all recall their first flight that kind of bit them, the bug. Can you recall that first flight?
Oh, but of course, because my second one, my first flight was free. My second one was in my own balloon.
Your own balloon?
Yeah. I went back in early 70. I guess 77, and got hooked on it, and a few months later I had my home.
Any unusual stories as far as landings or ascensions?
I've made one landing for every takeoff that I've ever done.
That's a great record.
Again, the thing in Moscow was last July.
What kind of a reaction did you get from the Moscovites?
Actually, it was wonderful. We were there with Mickey, and we had Red Square closed for 3 days for Disney filming. We left the little corridor open for Gorbachev and all the officials to get in. We left there 2 weeks before the coup. But I was surprised. I found Disney in Moscow. I found Mickey Mouse comic books, and all the kids and everything knew who it was. We also had the people lined up. The Russian people were not allowed in the square when we were there, but they would be lined up, just thousands of people at each end of it. And they were curious to know what was going on, or just to, you know, to see something like a balloon. There was only one balloon in all of Russia at the time.
It's quite a goodwill ambassador, the Disney balloon. It pretty much brings a lot of smiles to a lot of people.
Yeah, I think so. I think it brings out the kid in all of us, which Disney does. We've all grown up with, you know, the Disney Company and Walt Disney World, you know, most of the younger generation now. And, of course, everyone just about for Mickey Mouse. So.
Sure. Thank you all very much, David. Appreciate your time.
And we'll see you at Walt Disney World.
Right. Good flying.
So. All right.
We're on the field right now with Kevin Flanagan from Scottsdale, Arizona, and you're a pilot on one of the balloons here. Kevin, how long have you been in ballooning?
This is my seventh year in hot air ballooning.
Now tell me, what got you interested in the whole project?
Somebody gave me a ride for my birthday, and the old saying is your first ride's anywhere from $100 to $150, depending on where you're flying. Your second one's about $20,000 by the time you get the equipment, truck, trailer, you know.
So, after your first flight, how long did it take you actually to get into ballooning? What is the process to become a pilot as you are?
Well, it's kind of like getting a driver's license. You need some practical training, you have to take a written test, and then you have to take a check ride with an examiner. You have to, in your practical training, you have to do a little solo time. So it's 10 hours for a private license, and that means you can fly your friends and family and anybody you promise rides to. And 35 hours for commercial, and then you can start going for hire.
It's a little bit more complicated than going and buying a balloon and getting up there in the sky by yourself. I mean, this is regulated by the FAA, isn't it?
Yep, it's FAA certified. The balloons are inspected every 100 hours or every year, whichever comes first. And the pilots go through biannual flight reviews and annual flight reviews if they're under 100 hours.
Now, this is competition we have here in Battle Creek. What is involved in competition? What have you got to keep in mind? What do you do in competition?
There's a lot involved. It's very complicated. We pick targets out, or the officials pick targets out on the horizon on a map, judging by which way the winds are going. And when you can steer a balloon, the different altitudes, the winds are at different directions and speeds. So you try and maneuver your balloon by using the different altitudes. Our only control is up and down. And try and come into the targets, which this morning were intersections of roads, and you throw your baggie down that's a bean bag with a tail on it, and you try and get it as close to the center of the intersection as you can.
How do you control a hot air balloon?
Well, the burner heats the air inside. We've got two burners on our particular balloon, and we're 80,000 cubic feet, and the temperature for a normal flight is say 170 degrees, and if I wanted to go up, I just coax that temperature up to about 200, and the balloon will climb, let it cool, and it'll descend.
So all you have is control up and down, or do you have...
Up and down. Up and down, and like I said, on a common day, the winds at different altitudes are different directions and speeds. So you could climb up to 500 feet and go to the right and go to 1,000 and come to the left, but it's all up to Mother Nature.
What is that experience like up there? I mean, is it changed all that much from your first to where you are now?
Well, it's kind of like magic. Disney couldn't put anything together that's as wonderful as flying in a balloon. And the different areas and different experiences, being that we go with the wind, we never know where we're going to land. So we always have different experiences along the flight. And we meet a lot of real friendly people. We land in their yards, and I've already had people invite us in for breakfast. And I've had people where I landed in their yards and they became friends for life. I'm still friends with them from just landing in their backyard. And other people come out and crew for you later. So mm-hmm. It's a real neat way to meet people and see wildlife. And, you know, the mornings are beautiful. And we fly the balloons at the sunrise and sunset of each day. And it's the two prettiest times of the day.
Well, Kevin, appreciate your time. And
hey,
we'll be watching you soar the skies over Battle Creek. And you'll be here for the duration of the festival here.
Yep, we're here for the whole 10 days.
Okay, wish you the best of luck. And we'll be watching.
All right, thank you.
We're talking with Deb and Phil Lang, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
You're official balloon chasers. What does that involve?
We got to go chase after Kevin and pack him up when he gets down.
I mean, you've got to keep an eye on him, and someone's got to steer.
Make sure he doesn't get into problems, or if he does have some problems, we're there. And just if he needs any directions, or if we need directions, we can get them from him.
Are you in contact with him anyway at all?
Yeah, we have a radio.
On radio?
Truck.
One's got to be navigating, right? I mean, mm-hmm. One's got to be watching the road.
Right.
I mean,
and then one is kind of keeping an eye on the balloon.
We try to make sure we're up with him.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of keep an eye on the map, see what we're headed for. You know, like if we have any big diversions, we have to go around like a lake. I know there's some lakes in the area here that we'll have to circumvent to get towards the target where he will either put down one of the two targets.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, you just try and go along with him. Or if it's a slow flight, you hurry up, go somewhere, and wait.
You've got to have an interest in meteorology too, I'd imagine, to get your pilot's license. You've got to know
definitely.
Something about
a lot of training in
mm-hmm.
the ground school with that stuff, weather and stuff like that. Yeah.
Phil and Deb, thank you very much, and we'll be watching what you do and keeping in touch with the balloon this afternoon. Besides the business of balloon competition, many were at Battle Creek for the pure pleasure of it all. Steve Derby of Illinois, a commercial airline pilot who's been a balloonist for 12 years, was there to just have a good time. He compared the ballooning experience to commercial jet aviation.
We concentrate real hard on making all our flights the same every day, and a balloon flight is different every single time. So
I see. Compared to flying an airplane, it is a lot more serenity involved in it.
Oh, a lot more. And you don't know where you're going, and you don't really care.
Uh-huh. One thing for sure, next year we will know where we're going, to the Battle Creek International Balloon Championship and Air Show. Drawing the world to Michigan, it's a must-see event for the entire family.
Michigan Magazine is being brought to you in part by Hale Hardware, your do-it center at Hale, Michigan. Much more than a regular hardware store, providing everything you need for whatever your project is, along with a knowledgeable sales staff to get her done. Serving Northern Michigan since 1946. Hale Hardware, south of M65 at Ainslie in Hale. Something special is cooking, hot and delicious. Indulge yourself at Morning at Maggie's in Bay City. Omelets, frittatas, hotcakes, and more. Make every day special with a stop at Morning at Maggie's for breakfast or lunch on Saginaw in Bay City.
Vacation. Don't make the planning of it more than what you're trying to get away from. At NorthernMichiganCabinRentals.com, you can choose from over 2,500 cabins, cottages, lodges, resorts, lakefront vacation home rentals, and more. Whatever experience you're looking for, from rustic to luxury and everything in between. No more rustling with telephone books. No more endless internet searches. Just one site with over 2,500 Northern Michigan destinations. NorthernMichiganCabinRentals.com.
Welcome to Uncle Cliff's Kitchen. Cliff Parent is Uncle Cliff. He's been cooking up wonderful dishes at his South Branch home for decades. A traditional cook, Uncle Cliff knows his way around the kitchen and has been sharing his knowledge and recipes with family and friends lucky enough to be his meal guests. Although a traditional cook at heart, Uncle Cliff is always open to new and exciting tastes. That's why we decided to set him up in a state-of-the-art studio kitchen and invite guests from around the state to share their recipes and mutual love of food with him and a studio audience. So, here we are at the Maytag store on Tittabawa City in Saginaw with the latest in cooking appliances and techniques with Uncle Cliff's first guest, Rod Nimtz, owner and chef at Morning at Maggie's, an omelet shop in downtown Bay City that features delicious omelets along with frittatas, French toast, and other breakfast goodies made to order. Today, Rod shares with Uncle Cliff a frittata and banana foster. Frittata is an egg-based Italian dish similar to an omelet or crustless quiche, enriched with additional ingredients like cheeses, meats, vegetables, pasta. Today, Rod is going to add a little fruit. Bananas Foster is a dessert made from bananas, a sauce made from butter, brown sugar, cinnamon, dark rum, and the butter, sugar, bananas are cooked, then alcohol is added and ignited. It's going to be exciting. Let's join Uncle Cliff and Rod in the kitchen.
Here we go. I think this should travel everywhere. Every time you do a show, you should have that blender should be in the kitchen and somewhere in the back. Your mom bought that for you?
Years and years.
Nice thick bread for you. The custard's already made, simple custard. It's cinnamon, egg, vanilla, a little bit of nutmeg. Okay. Again, we do the same thing. We throw it in the blender, whip it up, and we get a nice, frothy custard like that. To me, key is, Cliff, is...
soaking it.
Yeah, you want to make it happy, right? So get it in there, let it be a sponge.
Sponged up.
Yep. What we do differently at my restaurant than we do anywhere else is we coat everything with panko breadcrumbs. So the French toast just isn't in the custard. We're going to throw some panko on it, and we're going to move this along a little bit. So some butter down. And away we go. And there we are. But we're going to brown them on each side. We want to get the temperature on the inside of that going too.
The sauce you're putting on, is that just butter?
That's just butter. So we're going to let that French toast cook. We probably got about 7-8 minutes on that, Cliff. Cliff, do you know what makes Banana Foster?
Nope.
Other than the obvious that we just put the butter and the brown sugar in?
Brown sugar.
It's what's in this right here.
Honey?
No.
Brandy?
Yes. Spiced rum.
Spiced rum.
So, that's about ready to go, so I'm going to give you your bananas in there. And we are ready to go. We're ready for some flame. There. Okay, we're going to kill that. That is ready to roll. So, now we're ready to plate this. Now, you said you were hungry, right, Cliff?
Always hungry.
French toast. And here's your Foster's that Uncle Cliff made. This is a more of a Texas style toast, nice 1-inch thick cut. We soaked the bread in our custard, which is eggs, vanilla, cinnamon, nutmeg. Then we coated it in panko breadcrumbs. Placed it on the grill with a little bit of butter, browned each side, plated it. On the side over there, on Uncle Cliff's half of the kitchen, he made us a Foster's, and that consisted of butter, brown sugar, melt that together, dissolve the sugar, toss in some spiced rum, add the bananas, pour it over your French toast. Bon appetit.
Boy, that looks great.
Okay, first dish done.
And it was so good. Thanks, Uncle Cliff, to you and your special guest, Rod Nimtz of Morning at Maggie's in Bay City. Rod will be returning on a future show to share his easy frittata recipe. Plus, Uncle Cliff has a whole lineup of guests from chefs to home cooks from throughout Michigan. Thanks for joining us on our first edition of Uncle Cliff's Kitchen. You can contact Uncle Cliff about today's show by email, UncleCliffsKitchen@gmail.com. The Cedar Tavern and Grill of Lufkin, where friends come to meet friends and families come for delicious food and a wholesome atmosphere. Come relax with your favorite beverage or bring the crew for a great meal and live entertainment. It's happening now at the Cedar of Lufkin. Experience the beauty, artistry, and taste of Northern Michigan. Come to Amish Country Natural Products on Mount Tom Road, north of Mile, just off M33. From arts and crafts to fresh foods and vegetables, all natural, all local, all good. Stop by and get acquainted with Amish Country Natural Products, 1454 North Mount Tom Road, Mile. Hingeman Acres Canoe Livery and Resort on M33 just north of Mayo, catering to the outdoor enthusiasts. Cabins, canoes, kayaks, rafts, and more. Daytime or overnight trips along the world-famous Asabo River. A family getaway for over 75 years. Well, thanks for joining us. It's been a pleasure traveling the back roads with you. Now it's time to win something Michigan. This week's phrase is amazingly simple to fit the season. April showers bring May flowers. We're certainly looking forward to that, aren't we? You know the drill. The addresses are on the screen. Speaking of spring and flowers, we'd love to see how the blossoming is in your area of the country. Email those pictures along to us. We all need some wonderful inspiration. It's been a long winter. Have a wonderful week. I'm Barry Stutzman. See you here next week for another edition of Michigan Magazine. We'd like to thank all those that help keep Michigan Magazine on the road. Cops and Donuts Bakery, downtown Clare, a winning combination. Cops and Donuts. It's back and making memories for a new generation. The Rustic Inn of Lewiston, now open to chase away those winter blues with hot, delicious food, your favorite beverage, and an atmosphere that'll keep you coming back to make new memories and new friends. The new Rustic Inn on Red Oak Road, just south of Lewiston. Rose Valley Winery on Beechwood Road in Rose City. See what thousands are raving about, creating a delicious variety of award-winning Michigan wines. Stop by and taste for yourself. The taste of Michigan is yours at Rose Valley Winery. Introducing the Weed Gator. For safe and easy aquatic weed removal, the Weed Gator is the number one alternative to harsh chemicals. For getting rid of pond and lake weeds, safe and effective, see it in action now at weedgator.net. Made in the USA. Shopping for that special person just got easier when you shop at Rose City Drug at 2640 North M33, just south of the Rose City city limits. You'll find gifts for everyone on your list from 1 to 100. Shop online or in person at Rose City Drug, Rose City.